Hey, everypony, it's Tia Channel, and yeah, today is day two of BronyCon. Yeah, so for the first day of BronyCon, I didn't really get to record a lot because I was only there and I met BronyGuardian, and I had like, I went to like two panels. I went to an acid dazzling panel, which I got them singing on stage a little bit. I recorded that. And then I went to a Doctor Who panel, which we only like sat there and just talked. That's it, really. And then I met at the Acid Dazzling panel MLP Fluttersung and Silver Swirls. They are awesome. And yeah, you guys are awesome. Yeah, hopefully I can meet, if I can get this, I think it's the Minor Girl 87, I think. I don't know. Sorry if I get your YouTube name wrong. Either her or was it Neon Mushroom 84? One of you guys. But hopefully I get to see one of you guys at BronyCon. Sorry, I'm like half tired right now. It's like 9, 10 o'clock in the morning. And I'm just getting ready for BronyCon. And this is the outfit I'm going to be wearing. It's this shirt. And you guys can't really see it that much. It says 20% cooler, 100% Brony. And I ordered it off of Amazon. Then I'm wearing these shorts. Because, yeah, at Baltimore, for some reason, for BronyCon this year, it's like 80, 70 degrees. It is burning hot. You know, it's the summer over here. So, yeah. And then have my tag over here with the green thing so anybody can come talk to me. It says Tia Channel, of course, right there. Yeah. So, yeah, I will see you guys later when I'm at the convention. So, yeah, see you guys. See ya!
But, yeah, I do anything and everything to avoid work sometimes.
Woo!
Bro, you're good. You got you
a muffin.
To which, and after he bought the muffin, I remember that you can't eat muffins, so then we got you fruit.
Yes.
And then we were going to steal this muffin for ourselves.
Right? Okay, so you brought me a muffin, and now
I dropped it on my pants, and now it's all broken. So, yeah, here's your food delivery.
So it came to me as a real surprise. She
said, you know, you're here because when I went to describe the character and what it is that I was trying to do, I was explaining this to the suits, and the suits were kind of like, and she finally went, no, he's like Q on Star Trek. And they said, oh, my God, do you think we could get glasses? But I don't
see a bag down
there.
Yeah, no, there should be another one, like a carry strap.
At all. That just wasn't part of the way
that I was.
So the thing that is the same in all of my characters that I've played from the mud that I've been starting when I was 14 years old is that it's me-like. That's the same. It's filtered through me. But it's not, I don't argue that Discord is me. But I can tell you one of the reasons in which it sounds pretty close to it is that every character that's written, every script that's written, has its own rhythm and inner sense about it. And clearly, the way it was written, the Discord part, was written with that in mind, but nobody said that. So if you're hearing like an unusual similarity, it's because I'm just riding the waves of this particular script, and they happen to be intentionally unbeknownst to me, but intentionally like. Yes.
Okay, so this is good. And sorry if anybody asked this question yesterday. What was it like working on Breaking Bad?
Well, you know, I've worked on many, many, many different shows, but you know, within a matter of an hour or so, when you walk on the set, you know whether it's a good show. You just know, because everybody's at the top of their game. Everybody, the makeup people, the costumes, everybody is giving particular attention. There's a scene, those of you who are Breaking Bad, when I come in and I find my daughter in bed with Jesse. Okay, and I grab him and I drag him down the hall. And we're in a little living room. It was a bungalow that we were shot in. It was a practical set. It was a real location. Normally, in a regular television show, that would be shot in maybe about 4 or 5 hours at the most. At the most. It's a 3-page scene. You usually have 8 to 9 pages a day. You can't go 15 hours. It might have been the main scene of that day, but 5 hours was more than the amount of time. They had 2 cameras rolling at all times, and we started that scene at 10:30 in the morning. We didn't finish until 7. And part of the job that you have as an actor is that, there's a lot of work that's going on around you, but your job is to come there ready to go, ready. So there's a lot of tension. And ready to go means word perfect. To the T. And so I'm ready to go. And it's hard. But you usually get 1 or 2 takes. So you can imagine this. It's a very tense atmosphere. 3 takes and people are you're thinking, oh my God, I've really done a job, bad job. Well, I'm in it first take. Okay, let's do another take here. Well, if you get into a mindset about how you feel, then you tend to be general. And you don't want to be general. I'll give you an acting. What you have to do is heighten what you want. And in characters like this, who are sort of bald-faced egotist. And completely off the path. You just hype. Everything is hype. So it's not, I'm not in a mindset of a character. I'm just wanting something even more. So that's what I like. And that's what I'm thinking. What do I want? What do I want? What do I want? Yes?
First heard about bronies and what they were about. How did you feel?
Really weird. Okay.